Hello, my name is Eugen Detke. I am a member of the research group at the German Climate Computing Center. I was working with Julian Kunkel on an analysis workflow for identification of IO-intensive and potentially problematic jobs. And today I want to show you the results of our work. Here is the agenda of my presentation. I will start with monitoring data and give you an overview about capturing and transformation processes. After processing monitoring data, we define job IO metrics, which extract the key information from the monitoring data characteristic for parallel jobs. And finally, we apply these metrics on a large data set to identify IO-intensive and potentially problematic jobs. By the way, on the right, you can see the picture of Mistral, and below we can see find some key numbers. For example, Mistral has a peak performance of 3.1.4 petaflops. It has around 3,300 compute nodes, which in turn have around 100,000 compute cores and 266 terabytes of memory. For this presentation, it's important to note that Mistral has two file systems, which have the total capacity of 54 petabytes. One of the reasons for the project was a high interest in what kinds of jobs are running daily on our system. We are talking about 10,000 jobs a day. Surely you understand that a manual analysis of this number of jobs is not feasible. Among them are many good jobs that are using our machine efficiently. These jobs are not of interest. What we want to find are jobs which are wasting a lot of storage resources and can potentially degrade the file system performance. In this presentation, I want to introduce a workflow which is able to identify these jobs. Basically, it consists of two steps. In the first step, we define job metrics, and in the second step, we use them for ranking and comparison of jobs. Okay, let's take a look at the monitoring data. On this slide, you can see a rough overview of the analysis workflow. The raw monitoring data is located in the monitoring database. The data there is too fine-grained. The performance values were collected from probe files in 5-second intervals. Therefore, in the pre-processing step, our analysis tool downloads data for many jobs and converts it to 10-minute intervals, called the segments. It also computes mean performance for each segment. Then the segments are stored in a segment data set. After it grows sufficiently large, we compute statistics about file system usage, and based on these statistics, we are able to say to which category the segment belongs. More precisely, we are able to say if the performance is low, high, or critical. This category information flows back to the analysis tool, and in the second step, the analysis tool can use this categories information to assess jobs. For job assessment, the analysis tool downloads monitoring data, this time only for a job, splits it in segments, and determines categories for them. By looking at the distribution of categories in a job, we are able to say to which degree the job is IO-intensive or problematic. The picture on the left visualizes a generic example of monitoring data. The data has four dimensions that are the metric, client node, the file system, and application runtime dimensions. In this particular example, the data is captured on four metrics, on four client nodes, on one file system, and at 9 time points, from T0 to T8. Now the following three operations can be performed on all metrics. The first operation is the segmentation of the application runtime. Assume that the segment size is 3. In this case, the 9 time points can be transformed to 3 segments, and each segment gets mean performance value. Additionally, assume we have a variety metric with the observed performance of 200, 300, and 400 megabytes per second during the 3 time points. Then the mean performance for this segment will be 300 megabytes per second. The question is now, what kind of performance is it? Is it low, high, critical, or for this particular storage system? And to answer this question, we need a large number of segments to compute reliable statistics. This is what's happening during the second operation, the categorization. We apply two quantiles on a large set of segments to find two thresholds and to categorize performance into three categories. The performance below 99 quantile belongs to the low IO category, between 99 and 99.9 quantiles, to high IO category, and larger than 99.9 quantile to the critical category. You can see the summary of the criteria in the table on the right. You may wonder why have we chosen such high values for quantiles. The answer is because our goal is to find outlier jobs with exceptional IO behavior. This can be easily done by high quantiles. The first operation assigns M scores to the categories. Design 0 to the low category because it has a new because it is a neutral element in addition and will be ignored later in the calculations. To the high IO category we assign 1 to consider it in calculations, and we assign 4 to critical IO category because we could observe that performance of the critical IO category was at least 4 times higher than for the high IO category. And to make the calculations here, the weight must be also at least 4 times higher. Probably one of the most important advantages of this kind of data representation is that we have the same unit for all metrics and can use them in mathematical calculations. This is not possible if we draw data because the units are different. For example, now we can describe performance of a node segment just by summing up all M scores on a node. Or we can do a similar computation on a job segment just by summing up all metric scores on a node, on all nodes. Additionally, we can do dimension reduction and visualization more conveniently. In this visualization example, we have a job with a runtime longer than 10 hours. The segment size is 20 minutes. For simplicity, we have only visualized 3 metrics. The different color represents different file systems. Now we can immediately see that the job accesses both file systems during the runtime. In the picture below, the job view, we can observe two I/O phases. It is typical for parallel jobs to have one short I/O phase at the beginning, for example, to load data, and a long I/O phase during the job runtime, for example, for writing results. In the picture on the right, the node view, we can already see some strange behavior. For some reason, in the second phase, only three nodes accesses the last one file system. But nevertheless, the overall I/O performance is more or less balanced. In the picture on the left, the metric node view, it reveals more information. There we can see what kind of operations that are. The problem that we see is a huge number of metadata accesses and write calls. One question that immediately arises if the number of write calls cannot be reduced. In our experiments, a few write calls with large buffers are typically more efficient. Maybe this can shorten the second I/O phase. We could continue to analysis, but I think you can already see that the analysis of this representation is more simple, especially because only a significant I/O is visualized. Now let's take a look on how we can use this representation of monitoring data to extract the key properties of parallel jobs. The balance metric indicates how I/O load is distributed between nodes during the job runtime. We consider only I/O intensive job segments. That means with J score larger than 1. In the example on the right, only the first and the last segments are IO intensive, according to this definition. In the first segment, only one node is doing IO, therefore the balance is 0.25 for this particular segment. In the last segment, the IO is distributed over all nodes, the balance is 1.0. The mean value of the job is the job IO balance and is 0.625. We can say that for this job, the IO is balanced to 62.5%. Large jobs with a large number of IO accesses can induce slowdown on the file system for other jobs. To identify such jobs, we compute the job IO utilization metric that shows the average load during IO relevant phases. Assume that in the example, data is accessed on two file systems in parallel. For computation, we use again on the I/O intensive segments, the first and the last one. We find the highest metric scores for these segments on each node and compute the mean values. This is the utilization of a file system. To get the job I/O utilization, we have to sum up the mean values of each file system and get an I/O job utilization of 5. The job I/O problem time metric is the fraction of job runtime that is I/O intensive. It is approximated by the fraction of segments that are considered problematic, that means with J score larger than 1. In other words, the I/O problem time is the amount of I/O intensive job segments divided by the total number of job segments. In the example, we have two I/O intensive segments, the first one and the last one, and we have 6 segments in total. The job I/O problem time is therefore 0.33. We conducted a study on 1 million jobs and got quite interesting results. We captured monitoring data for 1 million jobs during a time period of 99 days. Unfortunately, only around one-third of this data was usable for our investigation. We could take only jobs from our main partition compute and jobs that we successfully completed. The table shows the results of the categorization with 99 and 99.9 quantiles. In the left columns, we can see again the 13 metrics and the corresponding units. In the middle, there are thresholds that were computed by the quantiles. And in the right columns, we can see the statistics of how many segments are located in the low, high, and critical I/O categories. The numbers are given in thousands. As expected, a vast amount of metric segments is categorized as low I/O. In the high I/O and critical I/O categories, there is only a fraction of them. The segments represent the highest performance that was observed on the client nodes during the capture period. You may also notice that the low number of OSC metric segments. The reason is that after a last upgrade, these metrics were not available, but since our approach was designed to deal with a variable number of metrics, we leave them in the data set. The left picture shows the balance distribution among jobs that are running on two nodes or more. Jobs that are running on one node are always balanced and are omitted in the picture. We can see that the vast amount of jobs are not using parallel I/O or doing it inefficiently. But the peak on the right also shows that there is also a group of highly optimized jobs that are running with almost 100% optimization. We have to keep in mind that during categorization, all negligible I/O, for example, with J score equals 0, is filtered out. What we see in the picture is significant I/O. The picture in the middle shows the distribution of the job I/O utilization metric. Since jobs with zero utilization are of little interest to us because they do not produce any noticeable load on the file system, they are omitted. The remaining are selected for the further investigation. The utilization for one file system may be at most 4. If the file system is used up to 100%, we can observe that many jobs have utilization up to 8. Which means that these jobs are using two file systems at the same time. For example, such jobs may move data from one file system to another. The right picture visualizes the job I/O problem time distribution. Surprisingly, when analyzing job I/O problem time, we found that around 65% of jobs are pure I/O jobs. That means the job I/O problem time equals 1. We can see that on the peak at the right side. You may argue that these peaks at position 1, 1/2, 1/3, and 1/4 are mostly artifacts from short jobs. But after filtering out jobs shorter than 2 hours, the peaks disappear, but the peak at position 1 is still there. And now we have arrived probably at the most interesting part of the presentation. It tells how we can use the job I/O metrics to identify interesting jobs. We express our interest by the so-called penalty functions. This function returns high values for more significant jobs. We just need to sort the jobs by the return value of the function and can pick jobs from the top of the list. This slide illustrates how the job I/O metrics can be applied to find I/O intensive jobs. Firstly, we need to express I/O intensity in terms of a penalty function. In this case, it can be done by the multiplication of all job metrics and the number of nodes. To find the most interesting job, we sort them by I/O intensity. Then we pick the top 20 jobs with a runtime longer than 30 minutes and visualize them in the left picture. The bars with the same color refers to the same jobs. In the right picture, you can see one of the I/O intensive jobs visualized as a job view. The first I/O phase is typical for parallel jobs, when data is loaded at the beginning. There is nothing strange. But in the second phase, we can indeed observe a strange behavior. The job creates files on both file systems over a long time period with 13 allocated nodes and producing a very high load on the metadata server. Probably this is worth a deep investigation. On this slide, we conduct a similar analysis to find problematic jobs. The idea of this problem score penalty function is that it helps to find jobs that are doing unbalanced but intensive I/O. To do that, we subtract the job I/O balance metric from 1 and multiply it by other job metrics. Many of the applications with a high problem score would have a long I/O phase, and parallelization of IO could possibly shorten the job runtime. By ranking the problem score, we can find the corresponding jobs. The top 20 jobs with runtime longer than 30 minutes are visualized in the left picture. One of them is visualized in the picture on the right side. Here again, we have a typical short phase at the beginning, followed by a long write phase by one of 70 nodes. Theoretically, with parallel I/O, the job runtime could be significantly shortened. This is the end of the presentation. Let's do a summary. We discussed the pre-processing of monitoring data with the three operations, segmentation, categorization, and scoring, to obtain a unitless representation of monitoring data that contains only significant I/O and allows mathematical computation. Then we derived simple I/O metrics from this data that describes the key properties of parallel jobs and showed how these metrics can be applied to find I/O intensive and potentially problematic jobs. So that's it. I thank you for your attention. I hope you enjoyed the presentation and have a nice day.